Hello students, welcome back to our channel Learn from Born Teachers. Today we are coming up with a new session of states of matter. In this we will be describing about gas laws. Before this we have done two videos talking about intermolecular forces. Before moving to the gas laws, first we should know what is state variable. State variables are those variables used to describe the physical condition of a gas. When you apply changes on gas, it changes its state, state 1 to state 2. So you can able to see that from the change in the variables like pressure, volume, temperature. Pressure was initially P1, it changes into P2. So these variables which changes are what we are calling the state variables. Pressure, temperature, volume, number of moles. So let us study about each state variables. First, we will be moving about volume. What is volume? Volume of a gas, as you know, volume of a gas is the volume of the container. So you should know the conversions as well. 1 liter is equal to 1 dm cube is equal to 1000 ml is equal to 1000 centimeter cube. 1 ml is equal to 1 centimeter cube is equal to 1 cc, you can write cubic centimeter. These are the conversions. Then comes another state variable, that is temperature. How will you define the temperature of gas? Yeah, it is a measure of heat content of a gas. It is a measure of heat content of a gas. Its units Kelvin, Celsius and Fahrenheit. Mostly we will be using the Kelvin scale. Okay. If we wanted to convert degree Celsius into Kelvin, what we have to do is, we have to add 273.15 to degree Celsius. If we want to convert degree Celsius into Fahrenheit, what we have to use is, you have to use this formula, degree Fahrenheit is equal to 9 by 5 degree Celsius plus 32. So this is very important formula you should remember. Moving to the next variable, pressure. What is pressure? It is force per unit area. Newton per meter square will be the unit. You are having the plenty of units, bar, atm, tor, mm or cm of hg, pascal, etc. You should know the conversion as well here. 1 bar is equal to 10 power 5 pascal, 1 atm is equal to 1.01325 into 10 power 5 pascal. That is nothing but 1.01325 bar. So these conversions you should know, definitely you should by heart these conversion factors. 1 atm is equal to 760 mm of hg. Now we'll be starting the gas laws. You know how many gas laws we have to study? Basically we have to look forward into four gas laws. So let us see which are all the gas laws we are going to study. First one is Boyle's law, then Charles law, Avogadro's law and Gay-Lussac's law. These are the four gas laws we are going to study, and combining these together we'll be getting the ideal gas equation. Now we'll start with Boyle's law. What is Boyle's law? For a given mass of a gas at constant temperature, the pressure of gas is inversely proportional to volume. Listen carefully. For a given mass at constant temperature, this law is valid only for constant n and temperature. Pressure is inversely proportional to volume. If we remove this constant of proportionality, we'll be putting a constant value K. K is a proportionality constant. PV is equal to a constant, so we can write. If a state changes from state 1 to state 2 at constant temperature, remember. So initially the pressure was P1, volume was V1. The changes from P1, V1 condition into P2, V2. So we can write as P1, V1 is equal to P2, V2. This is the important equation of Boyle's law. P1, V1 is equal to P2, V2. As per Boyle's law, we know that P is equal to K by V. So if you are plotting a graph between P, VSS, 1 by V, we will be getting a straight line. Okay. Remember, this is at constant temperature. So I am going to take this constant temperature first T1, then T2, then T3. Now a question comes. Which one is greater? T1 or T2 or T3? By the way, this graph at constant temperature is what we are calling this isotherm, as you all know. So let us check. How we will be checking that whether T1 or T2 or T3 is greater? This is done through ideal gas equation. We know ideal gas equation is PV is equal to nRT. So P is equal to nRT into 1 by V we can write. You can see K is nothing but nRT. So if K increases, we can say that temperature also increases, isn't it? So when K increases, temperature increases. From this equation, P is equal to K by V, we can able to understand if K increases, pressure also increases. That means if pressure is high, K also will be high. If K is high, temperature is also high. So you can link between pressure and temperature. If pressure is greater, then temperature is also greater. So you can say that T3 is greater than T2 than T1. You got the idea. We know P is equal to K into 1 by V. So V increases, obviously P decreases. So if we plot the graph between pressure and volume, what will be your graph? The graph will look like this. This is nothing but rectangular hyperbola. So if you plot a graph between pressure and volume at constant temperature, we'll be getting a rectangular hyperbola. At the same time, if you plot a graph of PV versus P, the graph will be straight line. PV is equal to constant, we know, right? So PV will be a constant throughout. Whatever the amount of pressure you are increasing, it doesn't affect the PV. PV will be a straight line. If you take log to PV is equal to K, you will be getting log P is equal to log K minus log V. Again, this is Y is equal to MX plus C. So we'll be plotting a graph log P versus log V. So what you are going to get is, you are going to getting a graph like this one. Charles' law. This law states as that volume of a fixed mass of a gas increases by T by 273.15 of its volume at 0 degree Celsius for every 1 degree rise in temperature. So the mathematical representation is Vt is equal to V0 plus T by 273.15 into V0. What is V0 and Vt? V0 is a volume occupied by a definite mass at 0 degree Celsius, and Vt is a volume at T degree Celsius. What this law is stating is, so if you increase the temperature by 1 degree Celsius, the volume will increase by T by 273.15 times of its initial volume. Plot a graph between volume and temperature for Charles' law, you will be getting a straight line like this one. If we extrapolate that line, it will join the x-axis where the temperature is minus 273 degrees Celsius. This temperature is what we are calling it as 0 Kelvin. So we are using here a new scale of temperature, that is Kelvin scale. What is 0 Kelvin? We'll be calling it as absolute zero. What is absolute zero? The lowest hypothetical temperature of 273.15 degrees Celsius at which all gases are supposed to have zero volume. You know, if the temperature is in degrees Celsius, how we'll be converting into Kelvin scale? By adding 273. That's it. Another definition is this. For a given mass of a gas at a given pressure, the volume is directly proportional to absolute temperature. So at constant mass of gas as well as at constant pressure, we can say that volume is directly proportional to temperature. That is V is equal to KT. V is equal to KT. So V by T becomes a constant. As we say, if a state change from state 1 to state 2, we can write it as T1 V1 to T2 V2. So we can write the equation like V1 by T1 is equal to V2 by T2. This is the important equation of Charles' law. V1 by T1 is equal to V2 by T2. What was the equation of Boyle's law? It is P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. So again, we have to plot a graph of charge flow. So we'll be having a graph of volume versus temperature. The graph will be, of course, a straight line. So we can say that it is at constant pressure. So we can call it as isobar as well. So if it is of different pressure, P1, P2 and P3. Again, a question arises. Which one will be greater, whether it is P1 or P3? How will be identifying that? Which pressure will be greater? How? Yeah, like the previous, what we have done in the Boyle's law, the same kind of methods will be followed. What method? We have to follow the ideal gas equation. You know, from the ideal gas equation, PV is equal to nRT. So V is equal to nR by P into T. So we can write it as V is equal to KT. From this, we can able to identify if K increases, pressure decreases, because K is equal to nR by P. So obviously, when K increases, pressure will be decreases. So we can say that K is directly proportional to volume. So volume increases, K increases. So K increases, pressure decreases. So volume increases, pressure decreases. So you can conclude that P1 will be greater than P3. So P1 greater than P2 greater than P3. This is how you can solve the question. See, simple. So this is how you have to practice. It is very easy. You can able to solve this. Now comes the Gay-Lussac's law. What it is saying is, for a given mass of a gas at constant volume, the pressure of the gas is directly proportional to its absolute temperature. What they are saying is, you should have a constant value of volume as well as mass. Then pressure will be directly proportional to temperature. You can write P is equal to KT, so that you will be getting P by T is equal to a constant. So we can formulate an equation, P1 by T1 is equal to P2 by T2. If a state change is happening from state 1 to state 2. If you plot a graph of pressure versus temperature, definitely you will be getting a straight line or slope. Again, the same question we can do. If we are taking different volumes, V1, V2, V3, what will be the answer for the question, like which volume will be greater? I think you can able to solve this, isn't it? So you'll be getting V1 greater than V2 greater than V3. You solve it by yourself, because the previous two laws we have solved the same method of question. Now we'll discuss about the Avogadro's law, the last law among the gas laws. The law states that equal volume of all gases under the same condition of temperature and pressure contains equal number of moles and number of molecules. What they are saying is, if your temperature and pressure is constant, then equal volume will contain equal number of molecules. Let us check. I am taking two beakers which is filled with gases of 2 liter volume each. So two beakers are there, each one carries 2 liters. That means we are satisfying the condition equal volume. Assume that temperature and pressure are same. So if the number of moles in the first beaker is 2 moles, the law is telling you that the number of moles in the second beaker will also be 2 moles. Simply, this is what you are Avogadro's law. It follows that at constant pressure and temperature, volume of gas is directly proportional to the number of moles of the gas. At constant pressure and temperature, here the amount of gas is varying. Remember, volume is directly proportional to number of moles. Volume is equal to Kn. We can write as V by N is equal to a constant. Okay. So for N moles, volume of gas, assume that it is V. So for 1 moles, what will be the volume of gas? It will be V by N. So that is what we are calling as Vm. Vm is nothing but molar volume. Molar volume. Molar volume is the volume occupied by 1 mole of a gas. Let us see. For 1 mole of a gas, at 1 atm pressure and 273 Kelvin temperature, the molar volume is 22.4 liter. What they are saying is, volume occupied by 1 mole of a gas at 1 atm pressure and 273 Kelvin is a constant value of 22.4 liters. This is what we are telling. So remember, Vm is equal to 22.4 liter at STP. What is STP? Standard temperature pressure. What is standard temperature? It is 273 Kelvin and its standard pressure is 180 m. Now we have completed our gas laws. From the next session, we'll be starting with the ideal gas equation. Okay. So this is all for this session. Thank you all. Please don't forget to like, share and subscribe.